Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Gilded Falcon of Istanbul. Chapter 1. The Sultan's Loss. In the heart of the Ottoman Empire, the grand city of Istanbul buzzed with life. It was a city of contrasts where East met West, and tradition faced the winds of change. At the center of this bustling metropolis stood the majestic palace of the Sultan, a symbol of the empire's power and grandeur. The palace, with its opulent architecture and lavish gardens, was a world unto itself, a realm where the Sultan reigned supreme. One morning, a sense of unease gripped the palace. The Gilded Falcon, an artifact of immense value and significance, had vanished. This was no ordinary piece of art. It was a masterwork of Ottoman craftsmanship, its wings delicately crafted from the finest gold and its eyes set with rare gems. More than its material worth, the falcon was a symbol of the Sultan's absolute power and the empire's soaring aspirations. Through the palace hallways, word of the robbery quickly traveled, reaching the ears of the Sultan's most trusted investigator, Amir Kadir. Kadir was a man of great intelligence and experience who was renowned for his ability to solve even the most difficult puzzles. His notoriety was so great that not even the murmurs from the shadowy corners of the city could elude his perceptive ears. The Sultan, demanding discretion and swift action, summoned Kadir. In the opulent throne room, adorned with intricate tapestries and glimmering chandeliers, the Sultan briefed Kadir on the situation. The loss of the Gilded Falcon was not just a matter of stolen property, it was a blow to the Sultan's prestige, and if word got out, it could be seen as a sign of weakening power. Kadir listened intently, his mind already weaving through the possibilities and motives behind the theft. He knew the task ahead would be challenging. The thief was bold and cunning, having managed to breach the palace's tight security and escape undetected with the valuable artifact. His investigation began in the heart of the palace. Kadir meticulously examined the chamber where the falcon had been displayed. He looked for any signs of forced entry, any clues left behind by the thief. The room, however, revealed little. The theft had been executed flawlessly. Kadir then turned to the palace's inhabitants. He interviewed guards, servants, and courtiers, searching for any anomaly in their accounts, any hint of deceit. The palace was a world of intricate hierarchies and hidden rivalries, where secrets were currency and trust was a rare commodity. As he delved deeper into his investigation within the palace walls, Kadir became acutely aware of the undercurrents of tension and fear. The theft of the falcon had unsettled the palace's delicate balance, stirring whispers of conspiracies and plots. It was clear to Kadir that the theft was more than a simple act of greed. It was a statement, a challenge to the Sultan's authority. Realizing that the answers he sought might lie beyond the palace, Kadir decided to venture into the city. Istanbul was a melting pot of cultures, a place where fortunes were made and lost every day, and secrets were hidden in plain sight. The city's bazaars, with their endless array of stalls and shops, were a good place to start. It was there that goods of all origins were traded, and information flowed as freely as the waters of the Bosphorus. Kadir's journey took him through the winding streets of Istanbul, past grand mosques and through bustling markets. The air was filled with the scent of spices and the sound of merchants hawking their wares. Kadir's presence did not go unnoticed. His reputation had preceded him, and whispers followed in his wake. In the bazaars, Kadir's inquiries were met with a mix of curiosity and wariness. The traders and shopkeepers, with their own networks of information, were a valuable resource in his investigation. Kadir sifted through rumors and hearsay, looking for that crucial piece of information that could lead him to the Falcon. As the sun set over Istanbul, casting a golden hue over its skyline, Kadir knew that his quest to find the Gilded Falcon would take him into the heart of the city's complexities. He would have to navigate the intricate web of alliances and rivalries, delve into the opulent world of the city's elite, and explore the shadowy corners of its underworld. The theft of the Gilded Falcon was more than just a crime, it was a mystery that weaved through the very fabric of Istanbul. And Amir Kadir, with his keen mind and unwavering determination, was set on unraveling this mystery, restoring the artifact to its rightful place, and in doing so, preserving the honor of the Sultan and the legacy of the Ottoman Empire. Chapter 2. The Bazaars and Palaces. The morning sun cast its warm glow over the city of Istanbul, lighting up its domes and spires, as Amir Kadir set out on his investigation. His first destination was the Grand Bazaar, a sprawling marketplace teeming with life and color. If clues to the Falcon's whereabouts were to be found, Kadir knew this bustling hub of trade and gossip would be a good starting point. Navigating through the maze of the bazaar was like stepping into another world. The air was thick with the scents of spices and fresh leather, the sounds of haggling, and the sights of vibrant fabrics and glittering jewels. Kadir moved with purpose, his keen eyes observing every detail. He was well aware that in a place like this, valuable information could often be hidden in plain sight. Kadir's reputation as the Sultan's investigator granted him a certain level of respect and fear, which he used to his advantage. He questioned merchants and stall owners, probing for any unusual activities or sightings on the day the Falcon disappeared. Many were eager to assist, offering tidbits of information, though Kadir had to sift through much hearsay and speculation. Amidst the chatter, a consistent rumor emerged about a mysterious figure seen near the bazaar on the night of the theft. This figure was described as being cloaked, with a distinct gait. While the description was vague, Kadir saw it as a potential lead. He delved deeper, using his network of informants within the bazaar to gather more information about this elusive figure. With each passing hour, Kadir's list of suspects and leads grew, but the true identity of the thief remained elusive. It was becoming clear that the theft of the Gilded Falcon was a well-planned operation, likely involving multiple players. Leaving the bazaar, Kadir decided his next course of action would be to visit some of the grand palaces of Istanbul's elite. The falcon was a symbol of wealth and power, and Kadir knew that among the city's nobility, there would be those who could be enticed by its allure. As he walked through the opulent quarters of the city, where grand mansions lined the streets, Kadir was acutely aware of the stark contrast between the lives of the city's wealthy and the bustling chaos of the bazaar. Here, behind ornate gates and guarded walls, lay a different kind of marketplace, one of power and influence. Kadir's presence in these circles was met with a mix of hospitality and guarded curiosity. He navigated the complex social etiquette of the nobility, engaging in polite conversation while subtly probing for information about the falcon. The palaces were a world of their own, with their own secrets and scandals. In one such palace, belonging to a prominent merchant known for his extensive art collection, Kadir encountered a veiled reference to the falcon. In the midst of a conversation about art and antiquities, the merchant let slip a hint of knowledge about a recent acquisition by a rival that matched the description of the falcon. This piece of information, though vague, suggested that the falcon's disappearance might be the result of a rivalry among the city's elite. The deeper Kadir delved into the world of the palaces, the more he realized that the theft of the Gilded Falcon could be a small part of a much larger game of power and deception. The artifact's disappearance could be a move in a high-stakes game being played by the city's most powerful figures. As night fell over Istanbul, Kadir found himself standing at the crossroads of two worlds, the vibrant, chaotic life of the bazaars and the hidden, scheming world of the palaces. Both held pieces of the puzzle he was trying to solve, and both were crucial in understanding the mystery of the Gilded Falcon. Kadir knew that his investigation was far from over. The next phase would take him into the darker underbelly of Istanbul, where the city's secrets were guarded by shadow and silence. The falcon's trail was leading him to the brink of the city's underworld, a place where the rules of the bazaars and the palaces did not apply. As he prepared to delve into this world, Kadir understood that the key to finding the Gilded Falcon lay in unraveling the complex tapestry of Istanbul itself. The city, with its layers of history, culture, and intrigue, was both his ally and his adversary in the quest to recover the stolen treasure. Chapter 3. The Underworld's Shadows. The city of Istanbul, a tapestry woven with tales of grandeur and intrigue, held its secrets close, especially as night draped its cloak over the ancient streets. Amir Kadir, after exploring the opulence of the palaces and the fervor of the bazaars, now found himself at the threshold of a different world, the city's shadowy underworld. Here, beneath the veneer of Istanbul's grandiosity, lay the labyrinthine heart of its darker secrets. Kadir's journey into the underworld was a descent into a realm where the rules of the bazaars and palaces no longer applied. The underworld of Istanbul was a nexus of clandestine dealings and covert networks. In this world, information was a prized commodity, traded and bartered like the goods in the Grand Bazaar, but far more dangerous. Navigating this realm required a different set of skills. Kadir, adept at reading people and situations, used his wits and intuition to guide him. He knew that in the underworld, trust was a rare currency, and the wrong move could prove perilous. His first stop was a dimly lit tavern, known to be a gathering place for those who operated in the city's underbelly. The tavern, nestled in a narrow back street, buzzed with hushed conversations and furtive glances. Here, Kadir met with a contact, a man whose eyes spoke of years navigating the murky waters of Istanbul's underworld. The conversation was cryptic, a dance of words and innuendos. Kadir's contact hinted at the involvement of a notorious thief, known for his skill and elusiveness. This thief, it seemed, had recently been boasting of a grand heist that would secure his name in the annals of Istanbul's criminal history. Kadir, piecing together the information, realized that this heist could very well be the theft of the Gilded Falcon. The description of the thief matched the mysterious figure seen near the bazaar on the night of the disappearance. Kadir pressed for more information, but the underworld was a place where secrets were guarded jealously. He left the tavern with a new lead, but also with the understanding that the path ahead would be fraught with danger and deceit. Continuing his investigation, Kadir delved deeper into the labyrinth of the underworld. He traversed narrow alleys shrouded in darkness, met with informants in secluded courtyards, and entered dens where the city's outcasts and criminals conspired. In each place, he gathered fragments of information, slowly piecing together the movements and motives of the elusive thief. As Kadir navigated this treacherous terrain, he became acutely aware of the undercurrents of fear and suspicion that ran through the underworld. The theft of the Gilded Falcon had unsettled the delicate balance of power within this hidden realm. Rival factions saw the theft as an opportunity to assert dominance, while others feared the repercussions of the Sultan's wrath. Kadir's journey also revealed the complexity of Istanbul's underworld. It was a place where survival depended on wit and cunning, where alliances were fluid, and loyalty was often a temporary bond. Yet, amidst this chaos, there was a code, an unspoken set of rules that governed the actions of its denizens. One night, in the shadowed corner of an underground gambling den, Kadir's persistence finally paid off. He encountered a figure from the thief's inner circle, a young man whose loyalty to the thief had been fractured by fear. Under the promise of protection, the young man divulged the location of the thief's hideout, a secluded spot where the Gilded Falcon was likely being kept. Armed with this information, Kadir prepared to confront the thief. He understood the risks involved. Confronting a criminal in his lair was a dangerous venture, especially in the lawless confines of the underworld. Yet, the recovery of the Gilded Falcon was imperative, not just for the sake of the artifact, but for the balance of power and order in Istanbul. As he made his way to the hideout, Kadir reflected on his journey through the city's different worlds. From the grandeur of the palaces to the chaos of the bazaars and the shadows of the underworld, each realm had its own heartbeat, its own rhythm. But they were all interconnected, parts of the greater organism that was Istanbul. The confrontation with the thief was imminent, and Kadir braced himself for what was to come. The recovery of the Gilded Falcon was within reach, but the final act of this intricate dance through Istanbul's hidden realms was yet to unfold. The city, with all its lairs and secrets, waited in silent anticipation, as did Kadir. He knew that the resolution of this mystery would not just mark the end of his quest, but also reveal the depth of the city's enigmatic character. Kadir arrived at the hideout, a nondescript building nestled in one of Istanbul's older districts, where the past lingered in the shadows of the narrow streets. He approached with caution, aware that the element of surprise was crucial. The world of the underworld was unforgiving, and the thief, undoubtedly, would be on guard. The hideout was as enigmatic as the thief it harbored. Hidden passages and secret rooms were a testament to the criminal ingenuity that thrived in the city's underworld. Kadir navigated these with the skill of a seasoned investigator, his senses alert to any sign of a trap or ambush. Finally, in a dimly lit room, Kadir came face to face with the thief. The confrontation was tense, a standoff between two individuals who had mastered the art of survival in Istanbul's complex landscape. The thief, realizing that escape was futile, revealed his motivations. The theft of the Gilded Falcon was more than a mere act of greed. It was a statement against the power structures that dominated the city, an act of defiance by those who lurked in its shadows. Kadir listened, understanding that every action in Istanbul, whether in the halls of power or the back streets of the underworld, was a thread in the city's intricate tapestry. However, he also knew that the Gilded Falcon's significance transcended personal vendettas or statements. It was a symbol of the city's heritage, a piece of history that belonged to all of Istanbul. With negotiation and the promise of a fair trial, Kadir convinced the thief to relinquish the Gilded Falcon. Holding the artifact in his hands, Kadir felt a sense of accomplishment, but also a deep reverence for the city that had birthed such a treasure. Istanbul was a city of infinite layers, each holding its own stories, its own truths. As Kadir emerged from the hideout, the Gilded Falcon safely in his possession, he looked out over the city. The first light of dawn was breaking over Istanbul, casting a golden glow on its ancient structures and modern facades. The city was awakening, oblivious to the drama that had unfolded in its depths. The recovery of the Gilded Falcon was more than just the successful conclusion of an investigation. It was a reaffirmation of the delicate balance that existed in Istanbul. The artifact's return to the Sultan's palace would restore a sense of order, but the journey to retrieve it had revealed the city's true nature, a confluence of history, culture, and humanity, forever interwoven in the tapestry of Istanbul. For Kadir, the journey through the realms of Istanbul, from its opulent palaces and vibrant bazaars to its shadowy underworld, had been a journey of discovery, not just of the Gilded Falcon, but of the soul of the city he called home. Istanbul, with all its contradictions and complexities, was a living, breathing entity, and Kadir, like the Gilded Falcon, was an integral part of its continuing story. Chapter 4. The Falcon's Return. The dawn light spilled over the rooftops of Istanbul as Amir Kadir, with the Gilded Falcon in his safekeeping, made his way back to the Sultan's palace. The city was stirring to life, unaware of the drama that had unfolded in its hidden depths during the night. Kadir's journey through the varied tapestry of Istanbul's society, from the grandeur of palaces to the clamor of bazaars and the secrecy of the underworld, had culminated in the retrieval of the empire's lost treasure. Upon his arrival at the palace, the sense of anticipation was palpable. The Sultan, awaiting the return of the artifact that symbolized his reign's strength and prosperity, received Kadir in the opulent throne room. The room, adorned with intricate frescoes and luxurious carpets, was a testament to the empire's power. Kadir presented the Gilded Falcon to the Sultan, its golden wings catching the light, casting shimmering reflections on the walls. The room fell into a hushed silence as the Sultan took the falcon into his hands, examining the craftsmanship and the precious jewels that adorned it. The return of the falcon was not just the recovery of a stolen item, it was a restoration of the Sultan's prestige and a symbol of the enduring might of the Ottoman Empire. The Sultan, relieved and grateful, commended Kadir for his unwavering dedication and skill. The investigator's success in recovering the falcon had proven his unmatched ability to navigate the complex layers of Istanbul's society. Kadir's reputation as a master detective was further solidified, and he was bestowed with honors befitting his service to the empire. However, the return of the Gilded Falcon was more than a personal triumph for Kadir. It revealed much about the city of Istanbul and the delicate balance of power within its borders. The theft of the falcon had exposed the undercurrents of discontent and rivalry that simmered beneath the surface of the empire's grand facade. Kadir's investigation had taken him through the city's grand bazaars, where trade and information flowed freely. The bazaars were not just marketplaces, but hubs of social and political interaction, where the pulse of the city could be felt most strongly. His interactions there had shown him the vital role these places played in the life of the city. In the palaces of the elite, Kadir had encountered a different aspect of Istanbul. Here, amidst opulence and luxury, he had navigated a world of intrigue and power plays. The palaces were centers of influence, where decisions that shaped the empire were made. The theft of the falcon had threatened to upset the balance in this world, challenging the authority of the Sultan and the established order. The underworld of Istanbul had revealed yet another layer of the city. In its shadowy corners, Kadir had delved into a realm where the usual rules did not apply. Here, in the labyrinth of the city's underbelly, he had encountered individuals who lived in the margins, operating outside the law's reach. The underworld was a testament to the city's complexity, a place where survival depended on wit and resourcefulness. The recovery of the Gilded Falcon had brought these disparate worlds together, highlighting the intricate web of connections that bound the city. Istanbul was a microcosm of the empire itself, a place where different cultures, social strata, and ideologies coexisted and interacted. As Kadir reflected on his journey, he realized that the true treasure of Istanbul was not the Gilded Falcon, but the city itself. Istanbul was a living, breathing entity, rich in history and culture, shaped by the countless stories and lives that intersected within its walls. The return of the Gilded Falcon marked the end of one adventure, but for Kadir, it was also a beginning. He had gained a deeper understanding of his city and its people, an insight that would inform his future endeavors. Istanbul, with its endless mysteries and tales, would always have more to reveal, and Kadir would be there to uncover its secrets. The story of the Gilded Falcon of Istanbul was one that would be told and retold, a tale that encapsulated the essence of the city, its grandeur, its complexity, and its enduring spirit. For Kadir, it was a reminder that within the heart of Istanbul lay an infinite labyrinth of stories waiting to be discovered, each turn and corner holding the promise of new adventures and revelations.